No one.
I got to get across the thing.
I told people to start their engines, but nobody's lined up.
What they gonna do when those start?
We're still trying to get the kinks worked out here on race number one. Look, that was fabulous.
Come on, they told you to start it. So I guess from what I'm hearing, we're starting parking today.
I mean, ain't no point burning up the tires, so it's that damn slow. We're just gonna park it, save the rubber.
All right.
Get four tires every other race.
All right.
The next race, we'll probably have better tires than most people, unless somebody crashes.
Well, I guess just keep it out of trouble out there, you know. Yeah. Well, do your best while you can. So I guess we might just pull it in after a few laps, just get it out there, but we'll be coming back and we're just trying to play the long game here, like you said, about tire conservation. So we're just going to take care of our tires today and come back better once we have a real race car. We got one right now as far as everything but the motor, but you know, we'll get the motor figured out. That'll fix itself. Well, now they're rushing everybody because of that old command to fire engines goof earlier. Yeah, I guess they're going to shore up the tire pressures and then we'll be out there. Just try to do the best we can while we can. Get my filming spot and let's go. Track ownership this year, so everything's still kind of getting itself coordinated. Thank you. First race of the year. That's our teammate, basically. There's the other Craig Moore car. I don't know if I got that on camera or not, but just, you know. Just first laps of the first race, you know, stuff happens. Second restart, or well, first restart, second start total. stocks are out now. 30 laps in the pure stocks.
Getting out on the track here, they warmed up for a 30 lap race.
Thank you.
how you doing this. They turned the lights off on the car. I'm gonna have a stroke. All right, restart this time for real. They bent the air filter. Thank you. 17 won it. 15 laps in the Hornets. After the race, would like to get that out of the way. Oh my gosh, dude. Yeah. By the two. I don't care who you are. In the air. I think Curran's got it locked up. We'll see. Coming to the checker. There we go. There's your runner. I don't know if I'll cover a lot of the late model race, but basically I don't have a lot of battery left. So if we have the battery, we'll cover as much of it as we can, but you know, I don't know if I'll even get the first few laps. Second twin. Not in it, that's good. Now I gotta go find where his car is.
Okay.
Oh, that's a wreck. Okay, we're good. Hope we'll see when they get this started again. As you saw, that was a pretty big pile up. Thank you. we're here with Chuck after the race. Figure we'd just ask him what happened out there about halfway through the limited race.
Well, I really don't know what happened. I mean, we was just sitting there riding the car. It was a little tight. It was just trying to use this race as a practice race and full practice. And I don't know. Just it jumped out from underneath. I don't have an excuse for it. It just did. Sucks because I don't think it got a clip, but I mean, it's bad enough. I didn't want to have to go back and work on the car, you know. I was wanting to work on it to make it better, not to fix it back. So. But we have to do that and come back and see what happens.
All right. Any sponsors you want to thank?
Oh, yeah. I want to thank Auto Villa, 86 Motors, Mrs. Graphics, and Chuck's Pizza Deli.
All right. Yeah, there's what's left of the car over there, and I guess we'll be back in 2 weeks.
Definitely.